The buildings to the university officials.
As soon as he agreed to sign it, he made.
What actions will you take if they attempt to force you out of the building?
Then we will be forced to fight. We intend to maintain this building. We have these guns for the purpose of self-defense. In fact, the police initiate any acts of aggression, then we will retaliate.
Is there any chance of a compromise, or must they meet all of your demands?
The demands are non-negotiable.
There's no deadline. You stay there as long as necessary. Is that
as long as necessary, correct.
Do all of you in the building have guns?
Majority.
We have enough guns. We have enough guns. Everything. You know. Taking on the building is an honor that our demands, our education is made relevant to black people.
Why have you taken over the building here?
Well, we issued a list of demands, the establishment of the Black Studies program, all faculty, all departments be headed by a black faculty member, that non-academic workers receive a minimum wage of $1.65 per hour, things of the sort. The school become more relevant to the community by establishing programs, adult education, tutorial programs,
How many people are in the building?
About 75.
Are the people outside here participating in this?
Yeah, this all black people participate.
Are any of the black community leaders supporting you?
Yeah, sure. The entire community is supporting you. We represent black people. The entire nation of black people supports us.
One of the university officials has said that you're being supported by outsiders. I'm not sure exactly what they mean. Is that true?
There are no outsiders. Wherever black people are, then they are our people. There are no outsiders. The only outsiders are white people inside this country. We aren't outsiders. No outsiders. Wherever black people are, they are our people. So we are represented by them.
Are you all Voorhees students inside the building?
Right.
Right. Everybody's a student, right.
Y'all have any food or anything in the building?
Students have brought us all the food that we want and need. Right. And they'll continue to bring food.
We intend to occupy this building until our demands are met.
I understand the president met with you earlier. What was the result of that meeting?
Yeah, we just said that we didn't want to talk. Only thing we wanted to do was him to sign, agreed to sign a demand. The demands will be met. You know, he wasn't ready wanted to do that, so we intend to maintain this building until he does.
So you wouldn't want to see the president again until he had a yes answer for you?
To sign the demands. You know, the demands, as I said before, non-negotiable. I mean, in fact, so we got it, you know. Black people work in factories inside this country making arms in Vietnam, so, you know.
Are y'all all members of any particular
group? Of the black population.
You're not a member of any group like the SDS or any organization.
I said we're a member of the black population.
We represent black people. No particular group.
How long ago did y'all make the decision to occupy the building?
How long ago did we do what?
How long ago did you make the decision to occupy?
It was just a question of time. So, you know. So we felt that it was the right time to do that.
Before occupying the building, had you attempted to negotiate with
several times. We attempted several times to negotiate with the same demands that we issued. In fact, in December, we issued the same thing. We talked to the Board of Trustees, the Chairman of the Board of Trustees, and nothing has been done. We tried through the Student Government Association to have those grievances redressed. They refused to do that, so we, you know, are forcing them to do that.
Spokesman,
would
you care to identify yourself, sir?
No, I cannot. I'm a member of the black population. Enough
of identity. Were you ready to go into the bitter end, whatever happened?
Exactly.
They bring in...
Black people in this country are colonized in the society, so therefore we must prepare ourselves.
They bring in guns and start shooting you, stick it out.
By any means necessary.
By any means necessary, we're prepared.
The spirit and status of this great human, even after physical death, continues to live and grow. We are privileged to again hear the voice of Minister Malcolm X.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I welcome the opportunity to come into your home.
I would like to...
Help is not even on the way.
Every woman is right. Non-violent with those who are non-violent with me. This is intelligent. But just as you see other people doing whatever is necessary to protect themselves, it's time today for the 22 million Afro-Americans to feel free to do whatever is necessary to protect ourselves. We take an example in the Constitution that gives a person the right to have
non-violent means.
More than 200 South Carolina National Guardsmen, responding to a request from Voorhees College officials, moved onto the campus at 6 this morning. Only two of the more than 700 students were still on campus. They were arrested for trespassing. The All-Negro College, supported by the Episcopal Church, was closed last Friday after disruption of classes. Black students have two demands, the ouster of the Board of Trustees chairman, who is white, and the rehiring of four Negro teachers whose contracts have been dropped for next year. National Guardsmen were stationed outside the home of Acting President Dr. Harry Graham today, while a couple miles off campus, militant students were organizing.
The majority of faculty members are white people, and we feel like Voorhees College is turning into a white institution. And the question here before us is like, who gonna control our education? Whether we're gonna let white folks control it or black people. And the students at Voorhees College are taking a position that black people gonna control our education.
We like to denounce Governor McNair for again sending troops on our campus into our black community for the second time in less than 1 year. We feel that the problems in our campus can be solved within the community. We don't know why the governor is sending troops on the campus, and we don't feel good about this at all.
For weeks, there have been rumors that Voorhees College might never reopen. The acting president denies these rumors, but is now admitting that at least at this point, he doesn't have the answers on how to solve this present crisis. And he is only saying that it is his intention to reopen this college sometime. Phil Jones, CBS News, Denmark, South Carolina.